I would like to point out, I taught earth science for many years, and I'm pretty familiar with the arguments on starlight. We cannot measure those distances. They're guessing when they say, they're basing it totally on what's called luminosity or candle power of the stars. Nobody knows how far away the stars are. Actual physical measurements, of course, we can't even measure, you can't reach out with a tape measure and touch the moon, and it's only about 1.5 light seconds away, 240 some thousand miles. So the sun at 8 light minutes away, it takes the sunlight 8 minutes to get here. Earth's orbit is around the sun, is a big circle, which would be have a diameter of 16 light minutes. So if we translate this into inches, let's make our orbit around the sun 16 inches. We're going to pick a third point and make a triangle out of it and use parallax trigonometry to try to calculate that third point. If we get our third point 1 mile away, which would be 525,000 inches, if you had a triangle with 2.16 inches apart and the third point 500,000 inches away, which is 8 1/3 miles, that would make an extremely skinny triangle. That is the triangle you have to deal with when you're trying to measure one, O-N-E, one light year, using Earth's orbit around the sun as your base. I don't think we can know exactly where we were 6 months ago to even get that number precise. And all they really have to go on is looking at this star in January, look at it again in December, or I mean, look at it in January, look at it in June, and you're calculating the distance based upon how far out of parallel your lines of sight are in relationship to the diameter of the orbit around the sun. I talked years, and I'm going to tell you, I think that's a stretch to say you can measure one light year accurately, because you can't even locate your two points, January and June. But most textbooks will say you can measure 100 light years using parallax trigonometry. Well, that's like me putting two surveyors on the roof of my house here near Pensacola, 16 inches apart, and telling them I want them both to focus in on a dot in Chicago, and I want them to tell me how far away the dot is. They don't know it's in Chicago. All they know is they're both looking at this dot, and the only number they really have is the distance between themselves, 16 inches, and the angle that their telescopes are out of parallel. That would be what you would have to measure 100 light years. So when they tell the star is 13.7 billion light years away, I would like to know how they measure that and who held the other end of that tape measure, and was it a Lufkin, Stanley, or Craftsman? They could be. I'm not saying they're not. I'm just pointing out for the record, nobody knows the distance to the stars. They're guessing wildly based only on the luminosity, the brightness, the candle power. The assumption is, the inverse square law applies, that if a light is twice the distance away, it is 1/4 of the brightness. If it's 3 times the distance away, you take the 1/3 and inverse it, it's now 9 times. So I understand the inverse square law pretty well, but this quickly fades off to oblivion when you get into distances like, you know, hundreds or thousands of light years. The closest star is Alpha Centauri, in the Alpha Centauri group, called Proxima Centauri. The very closest star is 4.5 light years away, 4.3, I believe. Okay, that's the closest one. We don't know how far away these stars are. We just simply do not know. And to say that Jesus was incorrect when he said the creation of Adam was the beginning, based on somebody else claiming we saw a star 13.8 billion light years away, I think is ridiculous. Plus, I asked the question, how old was Adam when God made him? Well, he was 0. But he didn't look 0. He was a full-grown man. He could walk, talk, name the animals, and get married first day. So there has to be what some would call an appearance of age. Even though he's 0 years old, he wouldn't look 0 to us today, because to us, he would look, you know, 30, 40, 50, whatever he was, whatever his appearance would be. So I think God had to make a full-grown universe. Adam and Eve didn't get a package of seeds when God made them and said, plant these quick. They already had trees in the garden with fruit on them, which to us today, based on our life experience, would say, oh, this tree is 20 years old and is producing fruit. But no, this tree is 3 days old and it's producing fruit. So God had to make a mature creation. So why not have the starlight? Secondly, there are 17 times in the Bible where it says God stretched out the heavens. And if you start with the assumption that the stars are 13.7 billion light years away, then you do have to say, okay, well, they think the universe is 150 billion light years in diameter, the visible universe. Well, how did that happen in 13.7 billion years? All the textbooks, and I've just been doing research on this to add to my new seminar series we're doing for drdino.com. All the research indicates, they'll all tell you, the speed of light was much faster when the initial Big Bang took place, which I think is stupid, but that's what they teach. So this Big Bang took place, and for the first few seconds, everything flew out thousands of times faster than the speed of light. I don't think the speed of light is some kind of cosmic speed limit. Princeton University speeded light up to 300 times the speed of light, way back in the year 2000. There have been numerous experiments with the speed of light, speeding it up and slowing it down to zero now. They've brought it to a dead stop to analyze the photons. So I just would have to disagree that we should change our scriptures or change the clear, obvious reading of the scriptures based upon some current astronomer teaching 13.7 billion light years. And 15 years ago, they said it was 20 billion. 8 years ago, they said it was 16 billion. Now they're saying 13.7. They change it all the time. And I'm not going to change my Bible based on some flexible science. Okay?
Yeah. All right, Georgia, what were you going to say?
Could I respond to some of the things you said there?
Go ahead.
And we'll let him use his opening statement.
Okay.
You said the creation was the beginning. The creation of Adam was the beginning. Now, the creation of Adam was not the beginning. And sometimes Scripture is spoken not literally like you think it is. It's spoken figuratively. Even the disciples asked Yeshua, why do you speak to us in figurative language? Because he doesn't know speak literally. One time Yeshua said, Lazarus sleeps, so must go to well wake him. And his disciples said, well, if Lazarus sleeps, he's going to be okay. And he says, then he plainly said, Lazarus is dead. So Scripture is not always literal. And the creation of Adam was not the beginning. The creation of Adam was the beginning of man. But God created the earth before he created Adam. He created all the animals before he created Adam. He created the plants before he created Adam. So Adam was not the beginning of creation. And as for, you're telling me that, yes, if you just read Scripture and you read Genesis 1, yeah, you might think that it's 6 days old. But then you get to Genesis 2, and you didn't address Genesis 2, verse 4, which says that God made the heavens and the earth in a day. So either you have Scripture that contradicts Scripture, and then Scripture would be an error, or maybe your six-day creation of the heavens and the earth is incorrect. Maybe God did create it during a thousand-year span in the beginning, a thousand years of our earth, what we understand, which is a day to God, because Genesis 2, verse 4 says that God created the heavens and the earth in the day. And it was generations of time before he came back and formed the earth to sustain life, and he created life upon the earth. And that's my rebuttal, and I'll let you go to the opening statement.
Oh, I'm a little confused. You gave an uninterrupted opening statement, and I was giving my opening statement, I thought.
Oh, that was your opening statement?
I don't like debate formats. I just like to discuss the topic.
No, I understand. Okay, well, that's fine, but Genesis 2, verse 4, okay, where God says he made the heaven and the earth in a single day. How do you explain that?
Well, there are 31,000 verses in the Bible. I'm sure there's quite a few I did not address in my 10 minutes. Genesis chapter 2 is quite obviously a recap of only the events on day 6. And I cover this in my video number 7, Are There Contradictions in the Bible, which they can get from drdino.com. Again,